Hello and welcome to Coaster Gents. Today we're at Alton Towers Scarefest. So we've come down to Alton Towers today to have another full day in the park with Jake.
Me again.
Yeah. So we're not going to be doing all the mazes today. We are just going to be doing Freak Show and Attic. Because those two were the best ones that we did last week. I have done Darkest Depths twice and I've done the review on all the mazes. If you do want to watch that, there are non-spoilers and spoilers. There is a long warning before the spoilers, but it'll just be up here if you want to go and watch that. Also go and watch last week's vlog where we were joined by all the lads and we went in all the mazes and we had an absolutely amazing time. So today we've just come to do Freak Show and Attic and get on some of the rides. So we're just going to head over to Dark Forest again, just like last week and every time we come to Alton Towers, because if you start in Dark Forest and do 13 and Rita, they're dead in the morning because people start at Wickham and Smiler. So you'll get on them and you'll most likely get on Nemesis and Galactica as well. But anyway, I'll go and see you in the Dark Forest. Cola Freestyle, there's a hidden, kind of hidden Halloween option. Go orange.
Orange.
Yeah, so this is like blood orange with a bit of pumpkin spice in it. And it's actually really nice, isn't it? So, yeah, a little thing that Alton Towers are doing for Halloween. So here we go on a ride on the B&M Flying Coaster, Galactica. That was actually a really good ride on Nemesis just. Really smooth and yeah, it was really good, but now we're gonna go on Galactica. So I'll see you after this amazing coaster. And Darcy absolutely loved this when we came on it last week, but I didn't film a vlog, unfortunately. But she absolutely loved it and it was her first 1.4 ride. Anyway, I'll see you after it. After an amazing ride on Galactica, we're now going on Jewel Haunted House Strikes Back, which is an interactive dart ride. And it's actually, I really like this dart ride, not gonna lie. But like Jake just said, they put Halloween decorations on the gravestones.
Halloween decorations on a Halloween ride.
It's a shame they can't put it on any of the other rides, but just the Halloween ride. But we'll see you after our ride on Jewel, and hopefully I'll beat Jake. He says I won't, but I might. I probably won't. Oh, they've got a gun.
One of the guns. Jake's not for everyone.
Great ride on Hex. We're now going on Oblivion, the world's first vertical drop roller coaster that's not even vertical. Yeah, so.
Sorry, I'm just looking at the ticket.
Please remain. Yes. With your family.
So, once we've done this, it'll probably be time to go and do our first scare maze of the day, Attic Terror of the Towers. But I'll show you some clips of Oblivion, and yeah, it's going to be good.
From other guests. Please keep one chevron apart and always stop on a chevron when sleeping.
So we just had one of the best rides I've ever had on Oblivion. Not as good as the one on the other Scarefest day when we did it in the dark with the lights, but yeah, it was really good. So we're now on the Sky Ride, heading over to our first maze of the day. Attic, Terror of the Towers.
That was a great photo.
Yeah, that was actually a really good shot, man, I've got to be honest. The queue isn't actually that bad, I've got to be honest.
The gents are just
vlogging over. Jake's just filming.
Yeah, Jake's filming with my TV remote. But yeah, we're coming down the Sky Ride at the moment.
So we'll see you over at Attic, Terror of the Towers. Go into the first scare maze of the day, Attic Terror of the Towers.
Mask on this ride. Face mask.
Face mask on now, and I'll see you as soon as we come out of the Attic Terror of the Towers. Let's go.
Well, I was not expecting that. That was so intense, much better than the last run through we had. It was so much more intense, wasn't it, than last time?
Honestly, we had some fantastic scares in there. And you're not doing a spoiler review, so.
No, no.
Just fantastic, honestly, yeah. Fantastic.
So another thing which we didn't notice last Saturday was they put wooden floorboards,
so
and they were creaking.
Literally wooden.
Yeah, and they've got a wooden apex roof as well. So it literally felt like you were in an attic. The smell pods, there's temperature changes, all of this. Obviously, I'm not going to spoil the scares and everything and the scenes, but it feels like you're in an attic, and all the different things attack your different senses. So you have touch, you have the smell, you can feel the heat, see the smoke. It's just absolutely incredible. So we are just going to go and have a look around the park now, but definitely, definitely recommend doing the Attic.
Attic was a fantastic maze, honestly.
Yeah.
Definitely do it.
And the finale, without spoiling.
Scene, not spoiling it, it was 10 times better, and the lighting is so much better than last Saturday, honestly. That, in my opinion, I felt like I was more scared in that today than Oldville last Saturday.
Really?
Yeah.
I was too, yeah. His head was in Ella's bag last night.
Yeah,
Saturday.
I was so scared.
I went at the front. But anyway, that's a really good maze, and we're just going to head around the park now, so we'll see you. So we just had two rides, Congo River Rapids and Runaway Mine Train, and they were actually really, really good. I enjoyed them. Congo River Rapids was a bit weird, like we didn't get the big waves, but we got the little small ones.
Like little waves, which were quite good. KFC Mega Wave was non-existent on that because we didn't have enough weight, did we?
Yeah.
So if you had more people, it'd be more fun.
So the Scarefest atmosphere is starting to settle in now as it's getting a little bit dark, and all like. The nice lights are coming on, but I think we're going to go down to Tower Street now and have a look at some of the entertainment, as we haven't actually seen that yet. And yeah,
so obviously the Alton Ancestors are returning for 2020, and I'm about to show you some clips of their new dance for this year with all new songs, so let's get into it.
Kids screaming in the cradles, profanities.
Just ride around the nursery and catch you.
about an hour to wait for Freak Show, and all the rides are too long, all the main coasters. We're going on Get Set Go Treetop Adventure in CBeebies Land. I'll show you some on-ride footage of it. Oh my god, what are we doing?
Bug mug. And keep your hands, arms and legs inside the bugmobile.
There's so much to do here at CBeebies Land.
I don't think it's going to make
down
it up
below
here.
Is the Something Special Sensory Garden, ooh, where you can look, ooh, for the things in Mr. Tumble's spotty bag.
Why are we on this, actually?
I don't know.
Oh, what's ahead?
It's the CBeebies house.
Oh my god!
The bugs are all fast asleep.
If they aren't lucky,
as loud as you can to wake up the bugs.
Wake up, bugs!
Wake up, bugs!
Oh, okay. Oh my god!
I've never been on this ride.
Well done, everyone. The bugs are wide awake, so let's go on our way.
What? Awesome for Greendale. Would you like to come and join my special delivery service? That would be great. I'll see you later.
What do you think they're painting?
Bugs.
What sorts of things do you like to paint?
Myself.
The CBeebies bugs help
them. The main reason we came on this ride, isn't it?
I wonder what they'll get up to next.
CBeebies.
Actually a really good time in CBeebies Land this evening, yeah. Where we've done Octonauts and Get Set Go Treetop Adventure. Then we've just been in Towers Trading because today they released Scare Maze pin badges. They're really nice. They've got Altonville Mine Tours, Darky Steps, Freak Show and a normal Scarefest one that says 40th anniversary.
Darky Steps one and Altonville's not that nice.
To be honest, the Altonville one is... It's okay.
The Freak Show,
Freak Show one is the best one though. But yeah, we're going to go and do Freak Show.
We've still got about 15, 20 minutes. So
yeah, we've still got a while. And we don't want to get in the queue now because it won't be dark enough. So we'll get in the queue at 6:15 or 6 or whenever the ticket's booked for. But yeah, we're just heading down that area of the park now. And yeah, we'll probably try and get on another ride, but if we don't, we'll see you at Freak Show Toxic Junkyard. Barbed Wire Reclaim Yard, Freak Show Toxic Junkyard, our favourite maze of 2020, and it's going to be absolutely amazing yet again. So we'll see you after this incredible game. So we've just come out of the absolutely amazing scare attraction here at Scarefest, Freak Show Toxic Junkyard. That was honestly one of the best run throughs of a scare maze I've ever had. Over the past week, they've obviously improved the scares. They were doing so many more jumps in that maze than they did last week. A few spoilers from here, so just skip along about a minute. So they were hiding behind metal. They had big sticks with axes and barbed wire on the end that were putting in your face. The chainsaws at the very end in the killing grounds, where there was that much smoke you couldn't see them. They were also hidden behind metal walls, which was really, really good. The mirror maze is absolutely incredible, and all the bit where you go through like a pallet wall and there's bunting everywhere, that bit is absolutely amazing as well. And then the actual junkyard bit at the very start, I've gone in a backwards order here, but never mind. And then the actual junkyard bit at the very start is absolutely spooktacular. Yeah, instead of me saying amazing. Jake?
Oh, hello. Yeah, Freak Show. Oh, hello. Yeah, Freak Show is brilliant. Really, really enjoyed it. It's amazing. I don't know whether attic beats it or that. It's just,
yeah,
we just
today,
had a fantastic
today's run throughs. The run throughs that we've had today makes them quite on the same level, but I still really like welcoming. I'm sorry, but that is so close to welcoming. I think I'm a fan of outside mazes, to be honest. But not really sure what we're going to do now, but can you see all the smoke over there from Freak Show? Yes, we're not really sure what we're going to do now, but we're just going to have a walk around the park and take in the atmosphere at night and maybe do a few lights. Minutes for the world's most intense roller coaster. Well, it's not anymore, but that's what it was branded as in 1994. But we're going to go on it, and it's absolutely amazing. And I haven't done a night ride on it yet this year. Ashes burn everything you love and burn me. Ashes in the end, everything lights my childhood. Spend back all the malls of the disease. So we've come to the end of our absolutely amazing day here at Alton Towers Scarefest. This is genuinely one of the best events in the country, and the mazes are absolutely incredible. Freak Show and Attic are definitely the best mazes this year, but Mine Tours and Darkest Steps are still really, really good. We also have done Gardens Lights Walk as well, but we did that at dusk, so it wasn't really worth filming. But anyway, thank you for watching, and thank you, Jake, for joining me today.
Yeah, it's been a great weekend.
We've
done Drayton yesterday and Towers today, and it's been a great weekend.
Yeah, thank you. So thank you for watching. If you did like it, make sure to subscribe. Once you subscribe, make sure to click that notification bell so you'll be notified every time we upload a new video. And we'll see you in the next one. That's a spooky ride.